Tri-State, and Tri-State only insures good drivers.
Are you prepared to do your Dracula?
No. No. But that's a good question. No, I'm not prepared. I came here unprepared.
Isn't that the best way to come here?
Yes.
Are you looking at that college?
No, the best way is not to come here.
Yes.
There's no good way to come here. The best way is not to come here. Once you're here, then you're pretty much give up from there.
Here he is, Robin, Ophelia. Dracula Gottfried.
That's who I wanted to see.
Here he comes. Oh, my God. Here he is. Oh, man. Oh, my God. Look at him. He's beautiful.
I must wear earphones to speak to you.
Yes, you must wear earphones because you would not be able to hear me speak that clearly. Am I correct?
I hear you speaking clear. Very clear.
You know how long I've been waiting for you, Dracula Gottfried?
Millions and millions of lifetimes.
And your secret, you know, you're not the most handsome man in the world, but... In fact, you might be the ugliest man in the world.
But this Dracula thing makes you sexy, yeah?
Hey, Gilbert, can you start doing the accent when you do this? Because you look good. No, but in all seriousness...
I thought, you know, this is Gilbert acting, you know?
Right.
It's just as bad as when he was acting with Jackie.
Oh, this might be worse. All right, wait a second. I'm thinking, I gotta get Gilbert in a series where he plays Dracula. I'm going to make it happen. It's just going to happen.
And Jackie will be just one of the characters.
Right.
Jackie's acting is very frightening. He acts like the undead.
Dracula Gottfried, you are the type of man who can look at a woman, hypnotize her.
With your eyes.
And then...
Spread your legs open. I want you to spread your legs open now. Right now.
I was going to say.
And give me your kloogie. I want your kloogie now. Give me your kloogie now.
I was going to say before you interrupted me, Dracula Gottfried, that you are the only man alive that can hypnotize a woman, get her completely under your powers, and still not get laid. Isn't that true?
Yes. I can live 1,000 lifetimes and never get laid.
There's still not a girl in the world for you. Still not one. It's amazing.
Not one in the world.
And tell me something. You are a Jewish vampire, is that correct?
Yes. I don't drink blood on Yom Kippur.
That's right. Dracula yes. Gottfried. And you suck not only the blood out of people, but anything else you get, like a white shirt yes. or anything, or pajamas.
A
with
white
the,
shirt.
Right.
Cufflinks. Anything.
Anything that you
anything
can get.
Anything I could suck out of anyone.
In other words, that shirt that we bought you for this outfit, you will take that home with you.
I will take it home and sell it.
Right. Dracula Gottfried, Robin.
Show me your kloogie now.
Are you hypnotizing Robin Ophelia?
Yes.
Look into his eyes for a second,
all
Robin.
All right, I'm looking.
Show me your dark kloogie. I want to see it now.
Look at that. Pants coming off. Good for you. No, Jackie's pants are coming off.
Yeah, it's not working on me, but it's working on
Now, as Dracula, that means this is a rare appearance. We had to sneak you into your coffin because you have to, of course, sleep
well,
during the day.
Well, it's daytime.
Yeah, but we're in the studio, so it's
I
okay.
See, no, see? Or no natural light.
Artistic license.
Exactly.
Yes.
Yes. Well, this is exciting to see Dracula Gottfried.
Very exciting.
Will Dracula Gottfried be appearing anywhere soon?
Dracula Gottfried will be Unmarried with Children.
Oh.
Coming this Sunday.
Is that right?
Yes. This Sunday, Married with Children with Christine Applegate, who I looked at and said, take off your panties now.
Did it work?
And we had sex together. Many, many times.
I think somebody drove a wooden stake into your material today. Is that true?
I think, yeah, this outfit. Gottfried is making him unfunny.
Yeah, right.
It wasn't my idea.
It was mine. It was my idea.
It was a stupid idea.
I'm starting to reconsider it. Dracula Gottfried. Everybody loves him so much.
Yes.
The Jewish Dracula. And you went on Married with Children, and Christina Applegate ignored you too, didn't she?
Yes.
Was she hot in person?
She was hot in person.
And how long a shoot was this? I mean, was it one day?
It was 1 week.
Oh, 1 week of rehearsal?
It felt like a lifetime.
Did it? I can imagine.
What does Dracula Gottfried play on Married with Children?
Yeah. A Jew. A miserable, blood-sucking Jew.
Unbelievable. Well, by the way, for those of you who like this Dracula Gottfried routine, the Jewish vampire, tomorrow we're going to have the Polish invisible man.
And he's perfectly visible.
Perfectly visible. You can see him. It's unbelievable. The Polish invisible man. You're supposed to be undead, not unfunny. Now, wait a second.
Could you resurrect your humor?
Dracula Gottfried, so many great things. Tell me what you say when you see a victim for the first time. When you look into their eyes and you see a victim. How do you seduce your victims? Take us into the room when you are alone with one of your victims.
Would you like to have sex with a dead man? Would you like to hold my cold member in your hand?
Really?
Yes.
That's what you say.
My cold, shriveled member in your hand.
I think it's time to buy him free breakfast. Get him that stupid egg sandwich.
Shut him up.
All right, Robin, let's do this. Dracula Gottfried. Are we going to be allowed to speak to regular Gottfried?
Gilbert?
Yeah, Gilbert.
Is Gilbert here? I don't know.
Are you going to stay in character the whole time, you think?
No.
Good.
No.
All right, good.
He's dying to break up.
I think this was the biggest mistake you've ever made.
It looks really good.
It was a good it was a good idea for about a second.
No, come on. It's funny. It's funny. It was funny.
Yeah.
But I don't want to spend the whole day with you as Dracula.
Was this funny for even 5 seconds?
Yes, it was.
5 seconds?
Yeah. When I walked in, it was funny.
Do dice vampire. Is there such a thing as dice, anti-dice vampire?
Hickory dickory dock, a mouse ran up there. Oh! I wanted your pile of homo. You ever like the
There you go. I'll figure out what to do with this makeup. All right, let me take a break. Let's do some... You want to sit in with the news with us?
Sure, why not?
You like doing that. We'll have Gilbert Gottfried with us, who is dressed as Dracula.
For no reason.
So if you tuned in late...
You did Married with Children, huh? That's a pretty good
Yeah.
Who do you play? Seriously.
The same thing I always do.
Like an obnoxious guy?
Yes.
What are you selling something?
Yeah. Are you a salesman?
Yeah.
Do you really play a Jew? Do you try to get a date with Christina Applegate? Is that the premise?
No, I didn't have one scene with Christina Applegate.
What do you do? Like, what's the scene? I mean, what's the setup?
I'm actually playing me.
Gilbert Gottfried?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Why?
They get caught. This is the most ridiculous thing.
No, that's all right.
And
go ahead.
Stuck in
Dracula. I like it. I like the Dracula look.
Yeah. It's a good look for me.
So
it looks healthy.
Yeah, I think he looks terrific. Yeah. He almost look attractive. So he doesn't he?
It's like he came alive.
Yeah. Looks like
maybe you should wear white makeup all the time.
He's usually so pale. This actually looks like a tan, all this makeup. It looks all right. It's purple skin. No, what do you mean? Like, in other words, tell me what the characters do to meet Gilbert Gottfried, the famous comedian. How does that all work?
They're on a cruise.
Yeah.
And the ship sinks, and they're stuck on a life raft with me.
Oh, because you're the ship's comedian?
Yes.
Oh,
well, that makes sense. I was wondering where you would go to meet Gilbert Gottfried.
Yeah, on a ship.
A lot of people wonder.
Like Gilbert plays a cruise.
Right.
Yes.
Yeah. Like he would do, like he's so mainstream that people would want to see him on a cruise. What cruise is that? How many other comedians did they get to do to turn down the part before you went and did it? Were you the first choice?
Yakov Smirnoff had already turned it down when I took it.
I mean, that's totally ludicrous. I don't think Gilbert's ever been asked to play a cruise.
No.
Have you ever done a cruise?
No.
Because you're not mainstream enough.
Yeah. Gallagher turned down the spot already.
People who go on cruises are into, like, you know, traveling salesman jokes.
Yes, when Jackie Vernon was still alive.
Yeah, right. They would go that. I mean, this must have taken place. It's Married with Children the day after the world ended, and they're on a cruise.
That's one thing. It's the cruise to hell.
Yeah, and the only comedian left is Gilbert Gottfried.
Here's some slides from my vacation.
Yeah. What is it, Fafafui?
When you talk about Gilbert not being, you know, mainstream and stuff,
I think he's really funny. But have you ever heard the story about Gilbert opening up for Belinda Carlisle?
Yeah.
At the last minute?
That was the best. But one time, I guess somebody who represented the Go-Go's felt that like maybe they should get a comedian to open up for the Go-Go's.
Instead of another band.
Yeah.
But it wasn't Gilbert. The guy they got, whoever it was, got sick, and they needed Gilbert at the last minute.
Yeah, it's usually that's how it works.
Yeah. Who was the other guy?
It was like a mainstream guy. So, you know,
that's
you used
how
to
I got a lad.
I've been to like I've been to like a Go-Go's concert. Like it's all young girls
with their mothers,
with their moms. So Gilbert walks out, and he's not getting a laugh.
First, the guy told me there's a lot of little kids here with their parents.
Right.
So you should watch your material.
Right.
So for about 5 minutes, I tried to be clean.
And he really made an effort, but like it was like the crickets were heard in the background. Yeah, nothing was happening. Just, it's just bad. Five minutes into it, every vagina joke known to man. Gilbert, and I mean dirty, filthy.
I did jokes Jackie wouldn't do.
Yeah, right. It was just like
he wouldn't lower himself to do these jokes.
Right.
I saw a transcript of what Gilbert did in National Lampoon. Every third word started with the letter C.
Is that right?
Oh,
the C word for a woman's private part.
It was unbelievable.
So far.
To these little girls.
Did they boo you off and did you get thrown out? What happened? That's why I like you, because you're brave.
Yes. Or stupid.
Yeah, I don't know. What happened?
You don't laugh at Gilbert. Gilbert will turn on you.
Did you get yelled at by the manager and stuff?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Oh, that's why I love him.
Did they get the hook and pull you off?
Yeah, did you actually get, like, the lights go down?
People are standing off to the sides, and I'm just getting filthier and filthier, and they're, like looking like...
in shock.
Yeah.
You know what else is funny? Did you get paid?
Oh, yeah. But they were like...
Get off.
Yeah, they're just like waving their hand,
The other funny story is that Tom Chiasano, our general manager, booked Gilbert. What did you book him for again?
I booked him at a New York City Broadcasters, Radio Broadcasters Association.
Oh,
thing.
That was the worst.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know what happened?
Yes.
Tom always over the years heard Gilbert on our show and always saw Gilbert do it.
He's great.
He loves Gilbert. Right. Tom loves Gilbert, which you wouldn't know from looking at Tom. I think Tom says he loves Gilbert but doesn't really understand Gilbert's jokes.
No, not true.
But you really do laugh at Gilbert?
Absolutely. I think he's a riot.
So anyway, because he doesn't look like your typical fan.
Yes.
Right. All right.
Or maybe he does. We don't know.
I think Tom does it to be hip. But anyway, so it's sort of like he's the comedian's comedian, Gilbert. So Tom decides he's going to book Gilbert.
He looks like he's wearing the Dracula.
No. You ought to go back to your old hairstyle. Everyone tells me you look terrible on
TV.
It's
like Dracula and Son here.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm telling you what people say behind your back.
Okay,
because we were watching the Ralph show on the way down Atlantic City, the one, and you come in. Everyone goes, what happened to Tom's hair? He's like bald now, and you age poorly, and you didn't. It's just that hair just doesn't work for you.
You know, it's interesting because what happened the first time Tom appeared on the TV show was people faxed in and said, what have you guys been talking about? You always said Tom was good looking.
And he is good looking.
And it just doesn't come across with this new hairdo.
If I had Tom's face and my brain, there'd be no stopping me. I would have been in the movies 10 years ago.
You'd be
right?
Brad Pitt.
Yeah. Gilbert, wouldn't you like to look like Tom? Seriously.
Oh, yeah. Who wouldn't?
Yeah, look at that nose. Turn to the side. Let me see that profile. Look at that.
Oh, that's a Gentile nose.
Oh, that's past Gentile.
Yeah.
Don't block my camera.
It's beyond Gentile.
That's not a nose job, is it?
No.
Wow.
Nope.
He was born
genetics.
With that.
Thank you, Mom. Thank you, Dad.
If I was you, I'd go back to my old hairstyle, sew my mouth shut, and just keep going through life, man. Have fun. But anyway, so Tom decides to book this convention of broadcasters. Now, you got to understand something. Outside of New York, broadcasters are really square.
Well, this is in New York. This is a New York group.
Yeah. Oh, it was all New Yorkers?
I thought this was going to be like some hip crowd,
But because it was the whole state of broadcasting?
No. It was New York City radio stations, and it was up at Westchester Country Club.
Oh.
And it was the end of a golf and tennis day.
And
it was funny bunch.
And it was outside, and there's this little band shell that Gilbert's got to go in and play to the crowd
it
from.
It looked like that scene from Godfather 2.
I don't know how you could be a stand-up comedian. Yeah. It's so humiliating.
That's a horrible joke.
You got to go make those people
it
laugh.
It actually looked like a big shell.
Yeah, right. Yeah. It's an outdoor shell.
Yes.
It actually was.
Yeah. So,
Gilbert gets up. And this crowd is very social. They're all talking among one another. And Gilbert gets up and is doing clean jokes.
Right.
Nobody's paying attention.
Ignoring.
And Gilbert immediately goes to the vagina joke.
Right.
And I'm sitting there, and I'm laughing my head off.
But these guys are freaking.
No, and everybody's freaking. Gilbert does his 20 minutes or whatever it is, finally walks, the keys and the car.
I climbed over the hedge.
Yes.
Did you?
I didn't want to walk into the house. I wanted to get away. There was a big hedge there.
Because it had gone so badly?
Climbed over, yes.
You mean literally they were booing him and stuff?
No, nobody booed. But
they were staring. They had no idea what was going on.
Shocked silence is the best.
So the obvious way out is to walk through the house.
Yeah.
But you climb over hedges.
I didn't even want to bother. to go that long walk. So I climbed over this big hedge that was near
did
the house.
Did you see him do it?
Oh, absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Which did the whole audience see him do
more.
It?
I don't know if the whole audience did, because, but I had booked him. It was my responsibility. I'm going up to say, Gilbert, thanks. You know, I know. And all of a sudden, he's gone, walking through hedges. Through the.
And did you say to him, hey, I'm sorry, it didn't go well? Or
who could talk? He's like running through bushes.
Yeah. Really?
He's like.
I guess you paid him already.
He's like OJ leaving Bundy.
Yeah.
Wow.
So,
Gilbert, how embarrassing is it being you?
Yes.
Really? It's fantastic.
So a couple of the managers of the other stations came up to me. Some real conservative guys going, if that were me, I'd have pulled them off the stage after the first vagina joke.
So you were like really in bad shape. And what possesses you to do a vagina joke? I mean, is it something inside you go, I know these guys hate me.
Yes.
And I am now going to foul their minds.
I figured, what the hell, there's nothing to lose.
Let's go for it.
Yeah.
Wow.
Only I wouldn't even use the word vagina.
That would be too clean.
Yes.
That's too polite.
Nice. That would be for their kids.
Right.
No, absolutely. Yeah, I was trying to clean it up.
Wow.
It was right. It was so forever we are bound.
Well, there you go, Gilbert.
And then I had people coming over to me afterwards, like Tom, who were going, no, I thought it worked very well.
Yeah, you're climbing over the hedges.
Yeah, I'm climbing over the hedges.
A 6-foot hedge. Here's this 5-foot guy climbing through a 6-foot hedge.
And you know, Gilbert's not exactly athletic. For him to climb over that hedge,
it must have been hard.
For me to get on stage.
We'll be back with Dracula Gottfried.
All right. Yeah. Gilbert
stepped out of the room. He started panicking during the commercials. He decided that he wanted to take his makeup off.
Really?
So weird. Yeah.
Yeah, he really had one of those things?
Yeah. He was like, don't you think I should take off my makeup now? I said, no, it's funny. You look funny. I think I really should. So, because Ralph came in and fixed him up, and then all of a sudden he goes, why are you doing this? I want to take it off. So now he ran into the bathroom, and he's taking off his makeup because he feels stupid. He does that dumb show up all night.
And it does all kinds of stupid things on there.
Yeah. But now he's feeling stupid.
I thought it was going to be funny to have him sitting there acting like a regular person dressed
as
Dracula. Yeah,
he never knows what's funny. That's his problem. Wasn't it funny?
Yeah.
Him dressed as Dracula?
I thought he was out there getting touched up. I didn't realize.
No, he panicked and went into the bathroom. So you know what? I didn't want to deal with it.
What image is he trying to protect?
He goes, it was your idea to put me in this makeup.
Oh, now he thinks it's like that night with Tom out at that country club. He's bombing.
Uh-oh. Yeah, he thought he was bombing, but he wasn't bombing. He was funny.
Oh.
It was great.
I was kidding about his material, but it was funny. Anyway.
Getting sensitive on us.
So you know what? I said to Ralph, just do what he wants. Take off the stupid makeup. I'm not going to deal with it. Oh, here he's back.
I decided to come back in mid-transformation.
You're funny.
What's wrong with you?
You freak out over the silliest things. You make a total jackass out of yourself on Up All Night, and then you come in here. Hey, do you have a tan? He kind of looks like he has a tan under there.
I look like I have skin cancer.
And now you do.
It's like white pieces.
Now it's really funny.
There.
What happened? You panicked, Army, and you ran out. What happened?
Now I look like Dracula when the sun hit him.
Yeah.
You know,
just before he burned up.
Yeah.
You can keep the shirt.
No, I...
What happened?
I wanted to see if I could make it to the elevator. No, because it reminds me of all those times. Like, I one time saw Fred Travellina.
Right.
On Kathy and Regis Philbin dress up like Jack Nicholson.
Right.
And the bit immediately tanked.
Right.
In the first 2 minutes.
Yeah, but you didn't tank.
Yeah.
You didn't tank. You pulled it off.
You thought this worked well?
No, you're funny.
Great.
You did not bomb.
Yeah.
And you in that costume is funny. You can say nothing funny, and it's funny.
Yes.
Even the idea of you sitting there talking as Gilbert just is Dracula.
That's right. Now go back and put your makeup on. Let's send Gilbert out on the street as Dracula and let him talk to people.
Walk around.
Hello. I am Dracula Gottfried.
Nice to meet you, young Negroes. I am a friend of the Negro peoples. I like the way you dance and the rhythm that you're born with.
I think he should go out as Jewish Dracula.
Yeah, Jewish Dracula. You could take an OJ poll as Dracula.
Do you think OJ is guilty? Do you think he's a violent, murderous Negro? Do you just support him because he is a Schwarzer?
You'll get killed.
He is an animal.
What if he went out on the street? Seriously, now let's just talk this out.
You thought
another good idea.
Wait a second. I like this idea.
Oh, okay. Showing up as Dracula.
But you can't call black people
enough.
Negroes. They get mad. If you went up to a black person and said, "Hello, I am Dracula Gottfried, and I am here to take a poll."
Then they'd go, "Feet don't fail me now. Oh, I done seen a ghost."
And their hair would go straight up in the air.
Yeah.
You're going to kill me. Stop doing it.
So wait a second.
If he did, why are he walking around? Somebody done turned into a bat, and it was me.
We ought to meet black people will hold a tribunal, meet all the white directors that painted blacks that way. Yeah, wrote that junk, like big, dumb black people who can't figure out that it's not a real Dracula. But anyway, can't you go up to people on the street and go, like, "Hello, I am Dracula Gottfried.
I am Count Dracula.
Yeah, I am taking a poll. Do you think O.J. is guilty or innocent?
Do you think O.J. is innocent or is he the guilty animal hunted?
Bloodthirsty animal who caught up in the throat of an innocent girl."
What do you think? Could you pull that off?
I think it's one of those things that sounds funny up here.
Oh, no. It's going to be real funny. Would you do it? I'm not going to ask you to do something you don't want to do. But would you do that?
Hey, come on. This would be great.
Ask Jackie what he thinks.
I think it's funny.
I think it couldn't miss.
Oh, yeah. I think it could miss.
I'll send you out with the camera crew.
The Dracula pole.
Yeah, and then we'll listen to it from up here.
Send me out with a baseball bat.
Yeah. Yes. Yeah, but what if you went, "I am Dracula Gottfried." Yes. You know, nothing like too racial. Like you go, "I am asking people today what they think of the O.J. Do you think he is innocent or guilty?
Did he cut the throats of two people?"
Yeah, don't get into the racial stuff.
What about the blood?
And you could even say to him, "Are you voting this way because you are black?"
Black as night. Black as the low steps of hell. Black. Black.
Black.
You are black. Black as a nightmare.
Black as my cave. Without doing the racial stuff. Black as my cave.
Black as Transylvania.
Could you do it without slipping into the heavy racial stuff? Because otherwise you get beat up.
Yeah.
I believe that Gilbert will be as politically correct as possible.
You're right.
Looking into the face.
Hello, gentle
of those
person.
People on the street.
Hello, Mr. Black or African American.
Yeah, right.
Excuse me, Mr. African American.
My name is Dracula Gottfried. Do you say O.J. is innocent because you are black? Blacker than my cape in the deepest cave of Transylvania.
Blacker than the thoughts of a psychotic killer.
Why didn't Dracula ever bite black people?
Because
he had taste.
I couldn't resist.
I
just handed me a punchline on a plate.
Why don't you go out? Seriously, would you do it?
Sure.
But without going, don't go into the racial stuff so you don't get your ass beat.
Yeah. Or do it if you feel it.
Yeah, if you feel brave, I'll send you out there. Like, I'll listen through here.
Yeah.
You'll have a microphone in your hand. I'll have a camera on you, too.
Picture it.
And if you hear a fist coming toward my face.
Well, it's up to you. I mean, you feel you feel comfortable doing it? Just tell me.
You'll be out there with a camera crew. We'll send John and Gorilla with
Gilbert's
you.
Gilbert's a weird guy. I can never figure out if he wants to do something.
Sure he does. It'll be great, Gilbert.
Do you want to do it?
Or is this Gilbert harassment?
I'll throw in another shirt. I don't want to force you to do it.
Oh, boy, you'll throw in another shirt.
I think it'd be funny. Do you want to do it?
This looks like it was sewn right before I got here.
You want to do it or not?
I think I'll skip this one.
Will you?
Yeah.
Oh. It would have been a classic. It would have been a classic.
Offer him more.
No.
Offer him more. Throw in a CD player.
No, I think he's afraid to do it. He thinks he's going to look stupid or something.
Oh, yeah. I'm going to look stupid.
Are you worried
Physically or professionally?
Both. No, professionally I've given up on.
Right. Yeah. I can't imagine that you still have professional qualms.
Professional, forget about it.
He's physically John with
you. See, whenever I come up with an idea for Gilbert, he always thinks it's dumb. And meanwhile, it ends up being a classic that people talk about for years.
He questions
He becomes like so big. Like, he could fill stadiums just being Dracula Gottfried after this bit. But he will never be convinced that I know what's good for him. He will never be convinced. If I was your producer, you would be the hottest thing in the country. You don't know your own strengths.
Yeah.
You're like a basketball player that decides to play baseball. Am I right?
Try it, Gilbert. So, I mean, how could it be bad to do it once?
He just doesn't see the humor in it. He doesn't realize how funny it would be. You in a Dracula costume, interviewing black people
about the OJ.
And them looking at you like you're crazy.
Okay.
That's funny. Let me ask you about OJ.
All right, I'll try it.
You will?
I'll try it with four black people.
So okay, good. All right, good. Okay. Yes, go ahead, Robin.
Have a question.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Do you think this will work at all?
I know it will. Jackie.
It's going to be hysterical.
Wait, yes, Jackie. Jackie doesn't know a thing in the world.
Yeah. But just imagine, first of all, you're going to get the reaction because you're standing out there as Dracula.
This is
and
a guy.
The absurd idea of Dracula doing a pulse.
This is a guy who is as brilliant as Charlie Chaplin, but he's got the management of Judy Tenuta.
Yeah.
He just doesn't get what's good.
I think he's managing himself.
Yeah. All right, Gary, take before Gilbert changes his mind.
Yes, he'll do it with four
I gotta
black
have
people.
The Dracula makeup touched up.
No, this is funny the way you look now.
No. You slap that white makeup on.
All right, go out now and quickly, Scott, get the microphone set up and get Gilbert out on the street immediately. Quickly, take off your headphones too.
Hey, Gilbert,
cape is stuck.
Enjoy your career move.
You know it's gonna be funny.
Who fixed up the outfit?
And if you want,
boy, we spared no expense, did we?
Gary, you get the idea?
Yes.
All right. Do you think that's funny?
There's not even a question.
I know.
You're asking Gary.
Right. Take off your headphones.
Take off the headphones, Gilbert.
Take off your headphones.
I got my headphones on.
Now, do you want him to be made up again? Because Ross said it's going to take a little while, or should we just get him on the street?
Just slap it on quick. You do it. Forget forget Ralph. You just slap it on him.
I'm not the union, but I'll try.
Yeah, he's not either. Quickly go do that. Robin, out on our street right now is Dracula Gottfried. Is he out there?
He's been remade up, and he's out on the street.
No wonder.
Got a full cape and tent. Whatever that is.
All right, pull this up.
Oh, there he is.
Hi.
Hello. Dracula Gottfried?
I bid you welcome.
Tell me who you are.
I am Gilbert Dracula Gottfried. You are a black man, are you not?
Yeah.
Do you believe that O.J. Simpson is innocent?
He's innocent.
How can you believe that he is innocent?
He didn't kill his wife.
He did not kill his wife, even though his blood ran over their bodies. Do you still believe, even though he was found with the knife and with the blood and with the fingerprints, that O.J. Simpson is innocent?
I know he is innocent.
Ask him who did it, then. Well, who does he think?
Well, who exactly did this, then?
Somebody else.
Are you saying maybe a white man killed them?
I didn't say that. I'm not a racial guy.
Ask him, isn't it true that you are siding with O.J. because he's black?
Okay, are you siding with O.J. because he is a black man like yourself?
No. I think he's innocent because why should he kill his wife? Even though he's jealous, so why should he kill his wife? Why should a man kill his wife at all?
Well.
There is logic to this.
All right.
He must be innocent.
All right, send him on his way.
All right. I thank you.
Thank you, Dracula Gottfried. Now get up here quick for the news. The great Dracula Gottfried. He went back into the makeup for that. That was good.
I want to see that.
I'm going to tell him it bombed.
Oh, you're going to kill him.
No, you know. No.
He can't take that. You know it.
That's funny. Dracula Gottfried. And he's about 3 feet tall.
I know, he's probably looking up to everybody he's interviewing.
And you notice how he behaves?
Oh, yes.
In front of black people?
He immediately got into line. What did I tell you? He'd be politically correct.
No, you're a Negro.
I mean a black person.
I mean a black African.
I am too.
Yeah.
Right on.
I just like to see him squirm. Uh-oh. You were brilliant. You were brilliant out there.
Gilbert?
It was a brilliant idea.
Wow. You're really smart to go do that.
Oh, yeah. Nothing funnier.
It was an extraordinary idea.
Hey, Gilbert, not only was that good, but could you come in tomorrow as Granny Clampett? We could send you dressed up down on the street to interview black people? Boy, did you behave yourself in front of black people. Man. Yes. You were really a, oh, I'm a Negro too under here.
Yeah. I'm black like you, brother.
Yeah, brother.
Yes, brothers.
Thank you so much, Dracula Gottfried.
Yes.
Gilbert
Definitely
Gottfried.
Definitely the best idea you've had.
I'll think of some more.
Yeah. Going back outside as the Hunchback of Notre Dame.
Each time here goes a different character.
Yes. I'm going to be interviewing black people as the Phantom of the Opera next while I still have the cape.
You know what? I can't believe you're saying that.